Hello people and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will be showing you how to make a counter in PowerPoint. So first, let us enable the developer tab. So click on File, Options, Customize Ribbon and check mark the developer. Click OK. Now go to the developer tab, click on Label, it's represented by a capital A, and drag it over here. Okay, now go to Properties. In the name, change label 1 to counter and click on font. Click on the three dots here and change its size to 150. Okay, now change the caption to 0 and in text alignment, choose center. Okay, now we need to insert some shapes. So click on Insert, Shapes and choose the left arrow. Add it over here. Now copy and paste it. Select the duplicate shape, click on Format, in Rotate, flip horizontally and place it over here. Okay. Now choose an oval and put it over here and type in it exit. Okay, now double click your label and let us start typing our code. Now copy and paste this. Now instead of plus, type minus and change the symbol to minus. Now we need to add one more code, so write sub, exit and reset. So type counter.caption equal 0. So what happens is when you click on the shape which contains this macro, the counter should change to 0 and you have to exit the PowerPoint show. So in the next line, now close the VBA application. Now select the left arrow key, go to Insert, click on Action and Run Macro, minus 1. Choose the right arrow key, go to Insert, Run Macro, plus 1. And for the oval, exit button, click on Action, Run Macro, exit and reset. Okay. Now let us test our slideshow. Press F5 in your keyboard. Okay, now let us press the light button. So as you can see, it adds plus 1 every time you press this button and minus 1 every time you press this button. Now let us try the exit button. As you can see, the counter resets itself to 0. Now we need to save this file. Click on File, Save As. So choose your destination. I keep it on desktop. PPT counter. So you can save as a PowerPoint macro enabled presentation, which will allow you to edit your file, or you can save it as PowerPoint macro enabled show. So if you open that file, it directly opens in the slideshow mode. Okay, so save your file. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you really liked it, please press the thumbs up button and please subscribe to me if you want more tutorials like this. Thank you.